So we have been looking at constants of motion, okay? Last class, we derived, we showed conservation of total mechanical energy. The expression is epsilon is equal to V square over 2 minus mu over R is equal to epsilon. Okay. So this equation itself is called the Viswiva equation. Okay. I want you to remember this equation, and you may also need to know how to prove this in an exam. Again, I may give you a part of the derivation or the complete derivation. Try to understand how to derive this. Okay. We did this in last class. The second derivation you need to know is conservation of angular momentum. Okay. Now, typically, how do you express angular momentum? Angular momentum H is expressed as R. This is how you express angular momentum. What is this mv? This mv is just linear momentum. Okay. And r cross mv is the angular momentum. What we do is, just like what is this term in this Viswiva equation? What is this term, the first term?
Potential energy. Or
kinetic energy. Kinetic energy. But what? We use a specific term for it. What kind of what? Specific kinetic energy. Yes. So it is kinetic energy. Specific kinetic energy is because it is divided. Yes. Very good. So what is the expression for kinetic energy itself? 1/2 mv squared. And if you look at specific kinetic energy, it is divided by m. So it becomes 1/2 v squared. Okay. So similarly, what we do is we introduce this specific angular momentum h, small h, which is simply R cross B. Okay. And what we want, what I'll show you is, what this means is conservation of angular momentum or Here, this H is conserved or constant. Okay. Okay. So what does H dot will be equal to?
If this is constant, if this is constant, what is H dot? What is the derivative of H constant?
Zero.
Zero. Derivative of constant is zero. Okay, and that's what I'll show you now. Okay.
So if you recall the two-body problem, two-body problem statement is R double dot R plus mu over R square into R is equal to zero.
Okay.
Three cross the above equation.
So what will happen is,
okay, if I pre-cross, what's going to happen? R crossed with R double dot plus mu over R square R crossed with R equal to R crossed with. This is our cube, right? The two-body problem statement is our cube. You with me here? Okay, I've just pre-crossed this entire equation with R. Okay. So what is going to happen? What is this term? It will still be
zero.
What is this term?
One.
Think about it again. Dot product has a cosine. Cross product has a sign.
One.
Zero.
Zero. Why zero?
Because the sign of zero, which is the angle between zero.
Yes, so the angle between, so these two, think about these two, okay? The angle has to be between these two. What is the angle between R and R?
Zero.
Because zero. The sign of zero is
zero.
Zero. So this will be zero. Okay. So what you can write is, this implies R crossed with R double dot is equal to zero. Okay. What I'm going to say is, this can be written as the above equation expression.
Can be written as d over dt of r cross with r dot.
Okay, what I'm saying is this can be written as this, which is equal to 0. Okay, I'll show you a simple proof why this can be written as d over dt of r cross with r dot. What is d over dt of r cross with r dot?
D over dt of r cross with r dot is simply r cross with r double dot.
Okay?
Minus r dot cross with r dot.
You agree?
No.
Here, look at this as A. This is vector A. This is vector B. Okay? D over dt of A cross B is A cross with B dot. Okay? Minus B cross with A dot. This is the formula. Okay? D over dt of A cross B is A cross with B dot. So A is this cross with B dot. B dot is R double dot.
Oh, okay.
Right?
Alright.
Minus B is simply R dot. A dot is
R dot.
Okay. So what is this? A vector crossed with itself is always 0. Okay? A vector crossed with itself, regardless of what vector that is, a vector crossed with itself is 0. Just because there is a sine term there. And the angle between the same vector is 0. Alright? So this holds. Now from this, what I want you to see is
if D over dt of r crossed with r dot is equal to 0, what do you know about r crossed with r dot?
What is r crossed with r dot? Yes.
This is r crossed with r dot.
Right. V is nothing but r dot. Okay, so r cross with r dot is h, which is in r. You understand? What it simply is trying to say is the derivative of some quantity is equal to 0, which implies that some quantity here is nothing but is a specific angular momentum. Okay. By expression, it is specific angular momentum. Right? This is the formula for specific angular momentum. See that? So that is constant.
Here, I can say, can I write this as d over dt of h equal to 0?
So what do you know about H? This implies H is
conserved or constant.
Okay. So that is how you prove that the specific angular momentum or angular momentum of a system is conserved. Okay. Now what have we done until now?
We started
Just look at the root. We will just review a little bit about this chapter 2 or two bodies, this thing. We started with this, okay? R double dot plus mu over R cube into R is equal to 0. Alright? This is the, what is this? Two body problem state. Okay. We have also looked at R is equal to A square divided by mu into 1 over 1 plus E cosine theta. This is the solution to two body problem. Please review this lecture. This lecture, only two or three of you all attended this lecture. The lecture is up on YouTube.
Okay.
Please review this lecture. I don't expect you to know the derivation. So, I did the derivation how to go from here to here in that lecture. I don't expect you to know that derivation. That's a lengthy derivation. But what I expect you to know is, I expect you to know that, know this equation or know this expression and know what these quantities mean. I'll discuss those quantities. Quickly discuss those quantities. What is this H? Right. So here, see, there is a very noticeable difference between this and this, which hits you out. What kind of equation is this? What kind of equation is this? Look at this, okay? Does this look like a vector equation, vector differential equation?
Yes.
It's a differential equation, it's a second order differential equation. And these are vectors, right? This is a vector, this is a vector, this is a vector. This is a scalar equation. This is a scalar equation. And more importantly, it's an algebraic equation. It's not a differential equation. Is this a differential equation? There is no derivative of any derivative or anything like that. A differential equation should have at least one derivative. Okay. So this is an algebraic equation. Plus, this is a scalar. Everything here is a scalar. Okay. Now, what else did we? So here, H is also a scalar. It is simply the magnitude of this. Is this zero?
Yes. No.
This itself is not zero. This is a certain value which is the same throughout the orbit. Okay. If you take the derivative of this, it will be
zero.
So this itself is not zero. There's a difference. H dot is H itself is not zero. H is constant. Okay. Is this zero?
No.
Is this zero?
No.
So what is happening to R?
It's changing.
It's changing, right? If you look at the ellipse, that R is changing. In a circular orbit, what happens to R?
It's the same.
It's the same, right? But this, does that mean this is zero?
It means that the R is changing with respect to time.
Right. So what happens here is, what is the same in a circular orbit? Is this constant?
Yes.
R vector is not constant. If you look at a circular orbit, r vector, which means where does it start? It starts here. The magnitude is constant, right? But the direction is changing. You see that? So the vector is not constant, even in a circular orbit. The size is the same, but the direction is changing. You see that? Here, h, if you're looking at can you visualize this as an orbit? Okay, just visualize this as the orbit, circular orbit. Where is the orbiting body?
In the center.
Around. Orbiting body is not in the center. What is in the center?
Well, it's orbiting around.
It's where it's on the central body. So if you look at Earth is here, and the satellite or moon is doing this. So what is r? R is this, okay? But is it changing?
Yes.
It is changing like this as the satellite moves, right? If you look at r as just the distance, is the distance changing?
No.
No. Is the vector changing? Yes. Is the direction changing?
Yes.
Is the direction of r changing? So this is changing. You get it? Now, what is the principle? You have to watch the game. You need to watch the game. That's not acceptable. So look at why this is constant. Yes, so that this vector, now where is velocity? Now if the satellite is here, okay, now again I'll tell you, satellite is moving like this, it always is in this plane, but if this is the position, if the satellite at this position, what is the velocity vector? It will be like this. You understand? You agree? Velocity is tangential in a circular orbit, correct? If you take the cross of this, this crossed this, which direction will be that vector? Cross. Do the right hand rule. You have this. This is your R. Got it? This is your V. Where is the
sorry.
Is this changing?
No,
it's not changing. You see this, okay? Here, this is a vector. Here, this is that vector. Here, this is that vector. You see that? Is it changing? It's a constant. So this, neither the direction is changing, nor the magnitude. You see that? You see why the direction is not changing? Everybody sees that? Here, what is the direction of r? This, right? What is the direction of velocity? This. What is the direction of r cross? It's this. If you look at any this thing, this will always be the same. Okay. Now, r cross r dot, that is the reason I say, I showed you why the direction is not changing. Okay. Now, for a circular orbit, is the magnitude changing? R magnitude? Not changing, right? Is the velocity changing?
Sorry.
Yeah. Velocity is also not changing. It has to go at a constant. Think about, It has to go at a constant velocity. Okay. So this, if you look at the cross product, even the magnitude is not changing. You got it? Is the velocity direction changing? Velocity and magnitude changing in the circular orbit?
No.
Is the direction changing?
Yes.
So that is the reason this is changing. Okay. Although these two are changing, their cross product is not changing. Neither the magnitude is changing nor the direction is changing. Their cross product is not changing. It is always the same. Okay, you can always do this and you can say, so this, when you express rotation, okay, you can express it about one axis. You see that? The rotation is like this, about this axis. So this is what we did. We started with, this is the solution to two body problem. We looked at v square over 2 minus mu over r is equal to epsilon. What is this? This is the Biss-Weaver equation. It's conservation of, this Biss-Weaver equation is the conservation of total mechanical energy equation. What is this quantity? First quantity?
Specific?
Kinetic energy. What is this quantity? This is specific potential energy. This is the
total
mechanical energy. So total mechanical energy is always a, it is sum of kinetic energy and potential energy. So this increases, what happens to this?
Decreases.
This increases, this decreases. At any given point of time in an orbit. So when does, in a circular orbit, what is not changing? No, in the context of energy. Neither the potential energy is changing, nor the kinetic energy is changing. You see that?
Right.
Potential energy is changing. If potential energy is a function of what? Here.
R.
R, right? Is R changing? Here, what is this R?
It's the radius of the orbit.
It is the distance. Here, this r is merely the distance, it's not the vector, right? Is the distance changing? It is not changing, right? Is the velocity changing? It's not changing. What happens in an elliptical orbit? The r changes, right? So, when it is, I'll talk about the elliptical orbits, but if you look at the elliptical orbits,
this is just an example. So you have these two points, right, when you are drawing an ellipse. These are called the foci.
Okay.
So this is where the central body is. And this is the orbiting body. This is that r, the distance r. Is this r changing? What is the potential energy here? Now think about this. What do you know about the potential energy at this point and at this point?
This is greater where r is shortest.
Yes. So this is the potential energy is
maximum.
Minimum. Yeah, because r is the smallest, right?
Yeah. That's when
we're
in the passage, right? But
yes. If you just look at your basic understanding of potential energy,
okay,
this is the least. The kinetic energy is the highest here. The velocity is the highest.
Because it's closest.
It's closest. Okay. The energy.
You said that that part of potential is at its minimum, is kinetic at its max. That part.
Yes. So this is the central body. This is where the central body is.
Mm-hmm.
This is the path of the satellite.
Okay.
It's doing this. Okay. This is r at time t1. r1. This is r2. Okay. Similarly, you have v1 and v2. What do you know about R1 and R2? Can I say R1 is
less than?
Got it? Automatically, this has to be by this law. Okay, so when you're in an elliptical orbit, when you're closest to Earth, you're moving really fast. When you're farther from Earth, you're slowing down. Because this, the potential energy is the highest. Okay. So, the last thing we talked about, which was today, was H, which is equal to R cross with V, is constant. This is the
specific angular momentum.
Specific angular momentum. Or H dot is
zero.
Zero. This is conservation of
angular momentum.
I will assign problems, I will assign derivations. I want you to learn derivations for the exam. This derivation, and this derivation is important. I won't ask you this derivation. Okay? But you need to know this. You got it? You need to know this expression. You need to know how to use this expression. I'll tell you a simple this thing here. Now, since we have a few minutes, I'll just get you started with this orbit. I will need you to draw orbits and label orbits. Okay. There are essentially four shapes of orbits. What determines the shape? Look at this, okay? What determines the shape? This is also called the orbit equation. Okay? This is a trajectory equation, orbit equation. This will give you the path. Got it? Here, what quantity or what term should determine the shape of the orbit?
Theta.
Huh?
Theta.
Theta shape.
The H.
E determines the shape. E. What is E?
Eccentricity.
Eccentricity. So, just recall, this is nothing but, again, go back and review the lecture. This is nothing but equation of a conic section. We talked about conic section. Conic sections are of four types. Okay. Essentially, conic section is. Did we talk about conic section in this class? Yeah, you were there. Yeah, but did we talk about it here? I think probably not. So I'll just quickly tell you what a conic section is. This is an inverted cone.
I think we talk about conic section here itself, right? Yes.
So what are the four conic sections?
Okay.
So what we do is, eccentricity. E is equal to zero implies conic section is circle. Okay. E is equal to or 0 less than E less than 1. What does this mean? Conic section is ellipse. E equal to 1 is
parabolic.
And And E greater than 1 means? We always talk about, we'll talk a lot about these two orders. Of course, I need you to know how to draw any of these orders. Okay. But in general, what we'll do is, when we're discussing orbits, we'll talk a lot about elliptical orbits. So what is an ellipse? How do you draw an ellipse?
Like an oval.
You guys remember how to draw an ellipse? Do you recall how to draw an ellipse? If you want to draw an ellipse, you take two pegs. Okay? You knot a string, tie the string around it, and trace that. You see that? You take two pegs, peg it like, how do you draw a circle?
You did that in Calculus 1 in high school.
Yeah. So how do you draw a circle? If you were to draw a circle with a string and a peg, you would put it here, okay? You tie a string, you can trace that. You get a circle. Got it? You tie a string, you knot a string, pull it with a pencil, stretch it, and then go around. If you want to draw an ellipse, do the same thing, but two pins. You'll get an ellipse. Those two pins So let's say this is that one pin and this is the second pin, okay? So I want you to, for the exam, I want you to carry a string with you and learn how to draw this. String and pencil. I want you to carry either a compass or you know what a divider is? Just like a compass. Compass has, one has a, like a needle, right? And the other side is a pencil. A divider will have two needles. Okay, so you can divide things. You know what I'm talking about? Okay, so you take that divider, hold your divider like this, tie a string and so this, one of them is the, generally, these are the foci. These are called the foci. One of them is focus. Two of them is foci. So these are the two foci. Okay. Now what we'll do is we'll stop here. Today afternoon we'll discuss these. Please give me 30 to 40 minutes for today afternoon. Two to three. If possible, come to the class. If you have some prior engagement, you can just watch the video.
What is the test?
Test is.